In March this year, Barbara Atwine, a mother of three, collapsed dead at the police headquarters in Nagoro. Her death has since been linked to a Chinese contraceptive pill which is said to cause blood clots. Atwine's death came 6 months after the National Drug Authority banned the pill. However, it is still shocking that this contraceptive remains in circulation. Dr. Richard Mugahi, the Assistant Commissioner of Reproductive Health in the Ministry of Health, confesses that the Chinese pill remains in circulation despite it being banned several months ago.
It is an unfortunate story that we have the Chinese pill in Uganda because I call it unfortunate because the National Drug Authority that regulates the drugs that come in Uganda disassociated itself from its presence in the country. So it's here, not licensed. It was here illegally.
The Ministry of Health says they are yet to find out how this deadly contraceptive pill gets to the local pharmacies and drug shops. Hopefully, once its source is discovered, the ministry hopes it will be able to wipe it out of circulation.
The Ministry of Health, because the National Drug Authority had already put there a statement, we did not come out also to... We wanted to allow National Drug Authority to continue with their surveillance system because they wanted to find out where is it coming from, who is bringing it here, and right now they are in the field actually looking for this pill to get it out of circulation.
Meanwhile, over 16 African countries are in Uganda to discuss ways of improving family planning services in Africa. Key among the topics is making contraceptives accessible to all people, including adolescent girls.
Many of our countries are challenged with many issues that are emanating from young people failing to access contraception. For example, teenage pregnancy. That could be prevented if you make available contraception widely for young people to prevent pregnancies.
The issue of family planning is actually a development matter. As you've heard from our colleague here, the government policy is to make sure you empower young people, not only to get educated, to get skills, and get jobs. But if they don't use family planning and they are sexually active, they are going to become pregnant. Then all these things are interfered with.
Family planning is not about getting drugs and throwing them to the population, but also giving information about family planning. And this is exactly the engagement that Ministry of Health is having with the other stakeholders.
The Chinese pill is a once-a-month contraceptive pill. It is called a Chinese pill because its packaging bears no English wording except Chinese writings. According to the National Drug Authority, the pill was found to contain high doses of hormones above the recommended dosage and therefore has adverse effects on consumers. The risks associated with the use of this product include prolonged bleeding, irregular menstrual periods, palpitations, the possibility of blood clots and heart disease. It can also lead to cancer in the uterine area, plus infertility. Report by Rachel Nachuala for the news.